It's slightly terrifying.
On this episode of Make It Real, we're going to slap a jet engine onto the back of a motorcycle. And all this because we had the dumb idea to do so a few weeks ago.
So, to fill you guys in, Ian was an avid motorcycle rider.
I bought a motorcycle when I was 16, topped out at 220 kilometers an hour, and I had a tendency to take it that fast daily. I got some speeding tickets.
So many, in fact, that he lost the motorcycle. And he feels like maybe he's mature enough to own a motorcycle. So we
bought a very small motorcycle that I can be mature enough for.
Yeah, it's a CBR 250.
It doesn't speed.
It can't go that fast. But obviously, if it doesn't go that fast, it's also not that fun. So we've decided to strap a jet engine to the back. Yes.
What's in the box?
What's in the box?
When are we going to make a video on this?
Yeah, we really should.
Why don't we do it now? No.
Now, as you can imagine, jet engines aren't cheap. In fact, one of these babies is worth about $5,000, which is why we're super excited to announce this video's sponsor, World of Warships Blitz, who have helped us pay for a second jet engine, which we just ordered. That's right, when we get it, we might put two jet engines on the bike. Maybe. But I do know for sure we're going to be putting both of them on the spy car as well, and we'll actually have them raise out of the trunk. Oh, and with two, we'll also be able to try slapping one on each arm and flying like Iron Man. Or Richard Browning, the real-life Iron Man. Anyway, this is why sponsors are so important, because without them, we really couldn't be doing any of these projects. YouTube ad revenue isn't even enough to cover our normal expenses of running the shop, let alone these engineering projects. I wish it was, but YouTube seems to prefer promoting life hack videos and other- So, if you guys want to support the channel and help ensure we keep making cool projects, try World of Warships Blitz today. It's a tactical 7v7 player versus player game with great graphics and a huge variety of ships. With constant updates and new features, it is a ton of fun. When I was young, I used to love reading about naval warfare. My favorite book series was actually Horatio Hornblower. And now, thanks to World of Warships Blitz, I can live out my naval conquests in the game. It's fantastic. Plus, if you use my link below to download it and then get to level 5, you'll be automatically entered into my giveaway to win some awesome Hacksmith swag. Full contest details are in the description below. Now, back to the jet bike.
Yeah, and then so we'll put a bracket on here that then extends out and puts your controls there.
If you guys are curious about how this circuit actually works, check out the circuit diagram at maker.io.
So before we strap the jet engine to the bike, we have to make sure that it runs safely and reliably. In order to do this, we're going to attach it to our thrust tester rig that we built for flying like Iron Man and get some data out of it. We also have to make sure that our control circuit works reliably and is easy to use, because we don't want Ian fiddling around with it at 200 miles an hour. All right, you guys ready?
Loud noises.
Loud noises!
So this is main power. This switch will cause the jet engine to start idling, and this switch is 100% power. So for the jet-powered motorcycle, it is on or off. There is no ramp up, it is just go. I'm doing it!
It's unplugged.
It's not plugged in.
Ready?
sounds good for the jet bike.
All right, so 75 pounds of thrust might not seem like that much power, though 75-pound impact from Thor's heaviest hammer does a lot of damage. Now, the beauty with a jet engine is it's actually continually applying 75 pounds of thrust, whereas that was an impulse load of 75 pounds. To give you another example, we're gonna have Jordy shoulder check me to represent a 75-pound impulse force. Now, if someone applies 75 pounds of constant force, like Dave, I can resist it first, but then I'm going off the screen. That's how a jet engine works. So when we slap that jet engine on the back of Ian's bike, it's gonna get him going pretty fast.
We'll find out.
Yeah, good thing you're ready.
All right, it's ready.
Test it.
It's the ultimate blow dryer.
I could have hair like Captain America.
Alright, so to demonstrate the destructive and awesome power of a jet engine, we're going to be putting various things behind the jet engine. Which will also illustrate why we should never use this on a public road, because anyone who tailgates us will get burnt. So, let's start it up. We'll start with a styrofoam head and the new Hacksmith hat. Links in the description below if you want to buy one. But not this one, it's gonna not look good.
Oh, it tastes so good.
NANI?!
So we got the jet engine mounted to the bike, and we have the control circuitry also mounted. We got the display nice and visible on the handlebars, and we managed to jam almost everything underneath the seat, which is missing.
Yep.
There's the seat.
Let's do the startup sequence.
All right, who's holding the bike back? My crotch. It's a bad idea.
only 75 pounds of thrust.
You can smell it.
Giggity. So
that's what.
Hearing protection.
Hearing protection, baby.
Full power.
Ready?
You're not connected to the fuel tank. Stop moving. Drinks a liter of gas every minute.
Woo. All right.
Now we just have to take this to a drag strip.
It's not a ton of power, but
it will accelerate.
Power is the wrong word here.
Yeah, it's gonna be slow acceleration, but once you start getting up there, it's just gonna, I think it's gonna get you going pretty fast. You excited?
Oh yeah.
Until next time, subscribe now because we're testing next video.
It's slightly terrifying for a number of reasons. First, it's right behind you and you can't see it. So if something's going wrong, it could be on fire and you've got no idea.
Yeah, and then if you're probably have to wear some good motorcycle gear, flame retardant.
So then if you're at speed and there's this thing on fire behind you, like,
so you're saying it's a death trap.
You walk away. Maybe.
But the real question is, do you think you can get a speeding ticket now? No, I think this is gonna be really fun to test. Obviously, we're gonna actually have to find a track or a drag strip to test this because there's no way driving with a jet engine is legal by any means. It's definitely not covered by our insurance policy. So if anything did happen, we'd be screwed. But I feel like anything that we do isn't covered by insurance, so you know, whatever. Pretty toasty. All right, I don't know about you guys, but I am really excited to see how this bike performs on the track. Now, unfortunately, it is going to take a little bit of time for us to arrange a track meet to actually be able to take this bike and safely test it, especially because I don't really know where we're going to get insurance for this. So we're going to figure that out. But in the meantime, make sure you subscribe and get that notification bell rung because you're not going to want to miss this.
Ow!
Ha ha ha.